Now the job is to kind of use the reverse from what we were dealing with. In the previous problems, we were finding the missing coordinates. Now we need to create the drawing, right? We need to position and label the triangle on a coordinate plane. So let's start by drawing the figure itself and then adding in the coordinates later. So we have an isosceles triangle, RST. So first let's draw an isosceles triangle. So here's an isosceles triangle. I see it's got a base of RS. And so that means, well, I could put R here, let's say, S, and I know T would be the vertex. So if RS is the base, that means ST and RT must be the congruent sides. Now let's follow these instructions. Use the origin as a vertex or center line of the figure. Well, isosceles triangles have center lines right up down the middle, so we can use that as one of the axes. So if I've got my y-axis like this, I'd want to position it over the vertex of that isosceles triangle. So there I have the y, x. Next it says place at least one side of the polygon on an axis. Well, we've already placed the y-axis through the center line of the triangle. So number two, that suggestion says keep that other axis. Well, if we've got this horizontal axis, we should line that up on one of the sides. And so we could set that on as the x-axis here. There's the x and y axes. Now, we need to fill in this information that the base is 4a units. So in other words, this entire distance here is 4a. So since the isosceles triangle is split down that y-axis, 4a, there's going to be 2a units on the right side and 2a units on the left side. And so the coordinates of point S, I know its x-coordinate would be 2a, and the x-coordinate of R would be negative 2a. Again, since we're moving in the positive x direction and then the negative x direction. Now, since both points R and S lie on the axis, the x-axis, their y-coordinates must be 0. And then finally, point T. Well, I don't know exactly how tall this distance is, but I know that it might not be related to the number A, so I'll just pick something else. Point T lies on the y-axis, so its x-coordinate is 0. And then, oh, I don't know, B, let's say. So there we go. Let's try another. So here we are to position and label an isosceles right triangle. So an isosceles right triangle. So an isosceles right triangle, we want its positioning to fit so that the sides are on axes. Let me just change the color of this thing a bit. So we have our isosceles right triangle. So these segments would be congruent, and we have a right angle. Now, in terms of x and y axes, it should be pretty straightforward that the x and the y axis would fit in the corner, or in the right angle corner of this triangle. So there's our x axis, and the y axis we're going to fit right on that segment length. So we have triangle DEF, and we see its legs are both E units long. So this length must be E, and this length must also be E. And so that gives us enough information to figure out the x and y coordinates of these points. So I know that this point down here is going to be E units to the right and 0 units up. Similarly, this point up top is going to be 0 units to the left or right and E units up. And then, of course, the origin, that's a nice straightforward point, that's just 0, 0. And then lastly, we've got triangle DEF is the name, so it doesn't really matter where we put D, E, and F, so I'll just put them in those spots. So there we have the isosceles right triangle. All right, let's do one more. Oh, good golly, an equilateral triangle. It's called EQI. We have a vertex, and its sides are 2B. So first off, draw yourself an equilateral triangle. So we know its vertex is called Q. So, well, vertex, we've got a lot of vertices, but let's call this up top here is Q. I don't know, E, Q, I, so maybe point E and I. Now this is similar to that isosceles triangle that we were dealing with earlier. We want the x or the y-axis, one to fit on a center line and one to fit on a side length. So if we're dealing with the vertical axis, I would line that up right over that vertex. And then in terms of a x-axis, I think it makes sense to set that on one of the side lengths. So there we go. So now we have our x and y coordinates, or sorry, our x and y axes. We need to fill in what the coordinates of our points will be. So there's enough information in the directions to help us out. We already know Q. Q is at 0 and then square root of 3 times b, and the side lengths are 2b units. So all of these are 2b units long. Since that last side length, EI, is straddling the y-axis, I know if I've got a full length of 2b units, there's going to be b units on one side and b units on the other side of the y-axis. And that tells me the y-coordinate, or sorry, the x-coordinate of point I is going to be b. And since it sits on the x-axis, its y-coordinate is 0. The x-coordinate of point E will be negative b, since we're moving to the left of the origin, negative b, 0.